such a fleeting moment in time. Nothing remains, everything ends. You don't know how long I've waited.
Everybody, is my fucking microphone on? Hello, everybody. Welcome to the fucking stream. Say hello in chat right now. All caps. Hello. Period. Hello. Welcome, everybody. Happy Friday. It's Frienders Friday, you fucking losers. What's going on, y'all? How you been? I just ate a box full of donut holes, so I might explode at any moment now. But otherwise, I'm doing great. I'm feeling pretty good. We gotta play some more fucking Pokemon Coliseum today, man. We did all, like, a bunch of grinding last week. We might do some more of that now. I'm not sure. We might be able to squeeze by in that battle. But if not, we'll have to do some more grinding. Which is fine. Which is fine. That's, like, just part of fucking playing Pokemon. Sometimes you gotta do that. Especially this game. Hello? Uh-oh. Can I get rid of the fucking menu theme, please? Whew, that's a relief. I thought we were having some major issue. This is one of those days! Just made some chicken teriyaki. Mmm, yummy. Fucking yummy, dude. Oh, is it just the same theme in here? Oh, it is! That's why it didn't change. Because this room has the exact same theme. Okay, here's what we should do. Here's what we should fucking do. We should do the Coliseum because... We should do the Coliseum because we need more money! Because we don't have any potions. I remember that now. We did one before I ended the last stream. And we definitely need more. Definitely. Definitively. Oh man, I kind of want to swap out someone for Entei, just because we're gonna need them for that fucking... Nah, you know what, it's fine. I'll just leave him in there for now, and then we can pick him up later. I'm grinding Digimon in another tab? Jesus Christ, I don't need to hear about your personal life. Your what, Digimon? Yeah, let's do the fucking Coliseum. What fucking Digimon game are you playing? That you need to, like... I mean, I've never played a Digimon game, so it could be all of them for all I fucking know. That you need to grind in. Cyber Sleuth. Grind is very common in the series. Oh. I see. Did it fucking change my volume settings? I swear to God I turned this game down last time we played. Did I not? There we go. It's better. That's fucking better! I will not write an essay about how mad I am about it. Okay. Sounds like something that someone would say before writing an essay about it. If you ask me. No, chat, I'm not gonna write an essay. No, I'm not gonna write an essay. No, I'm not. I'm sure I must have said that on the stream at some point, right? When's the Koo Eater video essay coming? And I said something like, never. No, I'm not gonna write a video essay.
Write an essay, fuck it.
That's right. Missile, thank you so much for the 18 months. Listen to the mysterious voice. The Seaman essay? What the fuck am I gonna talk about Seaman for? What is there to say about Seaman other than, like, just experiencing it? Seaman needs to be experienced firsthand. Cool, your Lies of P video fucking rocked. Hey, thank you. Yeah, for anyone who missed it, I did release a new video this week.
Your snag balls look positively heavy today, boss.
Oh my god, thank you. Cool, Mark, thank you for the 31 months. Oh, also, I'm going to talk about it on the when we do art at the end of the stream, but Robin released a new highlight video of one of the Pokemon Coliseum VODs. So if you want to go watch that, you can. It's in Bone Zone Art in the Discord. Interpreting Seaman's teachings through a Marxist perspective. He did say some stuff that was like, oh, okay. Okay. All right, Seaman. Like, your guy. I didn't know you were chill like that, bro. He is surprisingly socialist. There's two girls, but thanks to the ravages of socialism, they have to share one cup. Oh, you don't like that one? Sorry, I'll reference a different TikTok next time. Oh, they didn't like that one. They didn't like that one. Have you actually been tricked into watching Two Girls, One Cup? No, I have never watched it. I don't intend to. There was only one of those. No, there was two. I remember I got with Meat Spin back in the day. And I also got with, oh man, this is probably one of the worst ones too. When someone would tell you to Google Blue Waffle. I got out with that one. Everything else I've successfully avoided somehow. Not Blue Waffle, bro. Yeah, man. It happened. Yeah, I don't recommend it. That one's fucking gross. I super don't recommend it. Like Neo in the Matrix, I successfully never saw Goatsy. Like, still to this day? Goatsy, I feel like everybody's got to see Goatsy at least once, right? Wow, that's incredible. I mean, it is just some guy's, like, asshole. It's, you know, it's really not, like... Honestly, out of all of them, I think Goatsy is, like, one of the more tame ones. It is just some guy's, like, bare asshole. Which is, like, you know, everyone's got one. Everybody's got one, man. Yeah, I never really used, like, 4chan or anything, so that's probably part of the reason that I never encountered most of these. At no point did I have any interest in showing myself horrible, traumatic imagery for no reason. My doggy is hyperactive. No! Is this what happens in chat when there's only 58 viewers? Damn! Fucking leave me alone, dude! You're gonna fucking cite my viewer count? Fuck off! Dude, they're beating the shit out of my Pokemon! We just started the stream. It's Pokemon. It's slow going. Don't look at me. Goatee is a topic of regular discussion here, actually. Yeah, we were talking about it on one of the streams that B was on. We were talking about it recently, but it happened in, 2019. I did a Jackbox stream where we were letting, viewers play with us. And we were doing that game where you have to, draw stuff and, give a presentation on it. And this was before B was ever, we were, talking or we were, friends or anything. B was watching the stream and playing with us, and B just drew Goatsy. And it was just on my stream. It's one of my top viewed clips. You can go watch it. And there was just a drawing of Goatsy just, on the stream. And this was before I had, a different page I could cut to. I didn't have one of these. I didn't have this. Nothing like that. I only had the one page. I don't even think I had a stream deck. So it was just on screen, and there was just, nothing I could do about it. That's legacy around here. Yeah, I didn't have Taiga. Nothing. Nothing at all. And that's why we love them.
Yep.
It's a great first impression. I let that guy onto my stream not long after that. So, you know, if you're trying to really get the parasocial relationship going, that's how you do it. That's how you can get it going, you know? You let that guy into your life. I did, yeah. Great. One of my best friends. Great friend of mine. Would have been really funny if they put that Goatsy up and you immediately cut to credits. I don't even think I had credits. I don't even know if I had a credits, an ending yet. I'm not sure. This was early days, man. This was early days. I had only been streaming for less than a year at this point. 90% of chat members stop just before the parasocial relationship becomes real. Keep fucking gambling, chat. Keep gambling. It'll work out, I promise. God, I love this theme. Yeah, double down. Double down. Start talking to the streamer like they're your friend. Be playfully rude in a way that only friends do to each other. It'll work. Trust me. Don't do that. Do not do that. You come too close, I'll make you into an example. You actually had the stream outro with the Auran High School song around the time of that clip. Just looked it up. Are you sure? Because I made that at some point in 2019, but it might not have been until after that. Anyway, like I was ever going to cut away from the goatee drawing. It's a very crude drawing, to be clear. It's very vaguely a drawing of goatee. That was concurrent? Okay. The researcher. Phoenix fucking checked his tome of knowledge. Perfectly crafted drawing of a man spreading his asshole live on Chatbox. Who has a no-fly list and all of you are on it, he told me himself. I did tell you that. The only part of my brain not wiped by Benadryl abuse. Oh my god. Only the things that had to do with my stream during 2019 and 2020. Dude, it's Grovyle! And a Lairon! What the fuck, dude? This shit's kicking up! They're not fucking around anymore. We should probably kill Grovyle. Immediately. Lizards versus cats. I've always thought of Umbreon as a dog, even though he definitely is more cat-like. Like, I'm in no way arguing that he is, like, designed to look like a dog. I've just always thought of him as a dog and Espeon as a cat. This is animals. This is animals. I would say Eevees are more dog-like. Look at Eevee. Oh yeah, for sure, for sure, for sure. They are Yuri. You know what? Yeah, you're right. They are both female Pokemon. I have a tendency to just do that specifically with Pokemon, where I just refer to every Pokemon as if they're a dude. It's a bad habit, but I just like I can't stop fucking doing that for my little animals. I'm a dude, he's a dude, she's a dude, we're all dudes. Dude, Gramble's like almost got his fucking meter all the way down. See, I just did it again. Music's so fucking dramatic. It's way too subtle. I want a banger. Coup evil arc never stops. He just misgendered this dog.
I'll misgender every dog in the city. And you could join me.
What the fuck, dude? That was nonsense. Come on, man. Bring out Small Finch. The no, not so small Finch.
Let live the Pokemon you love. or misgender the Eevees. Let die the woman you love.
Never forget the Dante's Inferno evil arc. What are you talking about? That was role play. That's different. I was not being evil. I was role playing as a part of the Catholic faith. That's what they do. That's what they do. It's not my fault. Oh, hey, I totally forgot to bring it up. Who? I should check before I say this, but I don't have the list up in front of me. Who bought me the fan last week on Friday? I'm going to turn this thing on. Let me see if we can hear it. I've got it on the loudest fucking setting right now. Sorry, the loudest, the most powerful setting right now. This is the most powerful fucking room fan I've ever had in my life. You don't hear it? I can fucking hear it. I can fucking hear it. It might not be picking up on the microphone, but that's fine. Anyway, I just wanted to say thanks for the fan. The most powerful oscillating fan that I'll ever own. It's like clearly a fan that's like not meant for like a small bedroom. But I put it on, I like set it up last night and put it on and just like had it on while I was sleeping, and I like accidentally slept way too fucking long. It was like the most peaceful sleep I've ever had in my life with this like extremely cold breeze blowing through my room. I've never fucking slept better. If it's in the room, it belongs here. Yeah, I mean, it definitely belongs here. But it's, like, clearly, like, the power of it is, like, meant for, like, a bigger room, because the lowest setting is, like, what the highest setting of my old fan was like. Ooh, focus punch. Makes the user flinch if hit by the target. Can I use this with anybody? I don't have, like, a fighting type. No. No, I super can't. If you don't have a fan on when you're sleeping, it ain't sleeping. That's what I'm saying. That's why I fucking had that on my fucking throne, bro. Because I was like, as soon as that fan broke, I was like, oh, dude, I need to get a new fan. This is not okay. Like, I am living unwell when I don't have a fan constantly blowing in my room. It's just not right. Something is fucking missing. If you have a Pokemon with substitute, Focus Punch is one of the best moves. Okay. Oh yeah, you're right. Wow, I didn't even think of that. That would be a really fucking powerful combo. My last apartment didn't have a ceiling fan, and that shit sucked. I'm so used to being surrounded by fans at all times. I'm not a big ceiling fan guy. They're okay. They like get the job done, I guess. Something about a ceiling fan makes me anxious. Because I've got this big thing that's constantly moving, dangling from my ceiling. Like, realistically, nothing will ever happen. As long as it wasn't, like, installed in a shitty way or something. But I'm gonna be thinking about it. I don't want that shit on my ceiling. The potential of getting flat Stanley'd. Let's go see if we can fucking take this guy on now. I think we might be able to do it. Oh, shit! Wait, I forgot to go buy potions. Fuck. We gotta do that instead. Mount Battle, Agate. Let's go to Agate. Buy potions. I'm in my mom's living room right now, and she's got the most powerful fucking ceiling fan in this room. It's still over 80 degrees outside, and I'm legit chilly in here. Oh, and the AC's not on? That's crazy.
We're winning it. Winning it.
Let's buy, like, 6 hyper potions. And some revives.
God, we really didn't get that much money,
to be honest. Pretty much just enough. The Shadow Pokemon Lab! Like, it's really not even hot in my apartment. Like, to be clear. Like, I have working AC. It's just that, like, the breeze is so fucking nice. It's like an instant buff. Weep, weep, weep. Like, thankfully, it's gonna start fucking getting a little colder here soon. Here in Michigan. I gotta fucking remember where to go. I recall this being very confusing. Oh yeah, this isn't it. Back up, back up! That stream where Koo put the AC ambient noise on, and that shit actually made me feel colder. Oh, you mean fucking, hold on. I still put this video on sometimes. Air conditioner sound. You mean this fucking video? There you go, I'll let you cool off for a second. The fucking setting on it that says 65. How can you not feel colder watching this video? What's up with the 5,000 dislikes on this video? What the fuck? I wasn't expecting to see a visible portion of dislikes on the bar. Putting my laptop on this? Alright, that's enough. You've cooled off. Oh man, where the fuck is this shit? Do I have to go down another one of these fucking elevators? This place is confusing! No, this is where you fucking, where you check the DNA samples. Can't run up the bill keeping it on all day. I just, like, I don't know, man. I don't understand, like, old people that just, like, just straight up don't turn the AC on when they have it. Just because, like, it saves money. Like, I don't know. I have to. How can you not have the AC on? Especially in a place like here where it's humid as hell. How can you just not have the AC on? I remember there was like a 3-week period in like 2020 or something, or 2019. It was one of those years. There was, like, my AC was out for, like, 3 weeks. And I streamed during those 3 weeks. It was, that was the most miserable fucking time of my life. I don't think I've ever been more, like, I feel like I'm gonna die. I can't believe I, like, survived that. It was terrible. Yeah, I streamed fucking Metal Gear Solid V at some point. And I was playing as, like, Ronald McDonald. It was, like, 93 and, like, almost 100% humidity or something like that. I was, like, losing my mind. It was terrible. Oh, you know what? I forgot to fucking get Entei, dude. That might fuck us. That might fuck us. Realistic African heat, it's immersive. It did feel like that. It was like, bro, I'm really there. Yeah, I forgot Dog too. I know. We might lose because we don't have him. So we'll see. Because his fucking fire attack is really good against the, like, Magnemite or whatever this guy has. Hello, Altaria. The other one. Uh-oh. No, we're good. Dude, what the fuck? This guy's kicking my ass! Does this game just give you less EXP than the handheld Pokemons? I don't know. It might be a combination of that and just, like, consistently encountering, like, higher level Pokemon. And also just, like, really good Pokemon. Like, we're really not that far into the game, and, like, this shit has already started happening. Fuck you, bro. Fuck you. Fuck you! All right, let's fucking get Granbull out here. With no wild buffer period, you kind of just need to adjust yourself. Yeah, I guess. Because there's no wild Pokemon. It's like you won't really level up naturally that often. What the fuck just happened to his jaw? No EXP share means you gotta level all them shits individually. Well, there's an EXP share item, but it's like, yeah, it's like the way it used to be where it's just a single item that only one Pokemon can carry. So there's no, like, party-wide EXP share. Nothing like that. Nothing like that. Bro. I like the addition of the fairy type. Fairy type is awesome. Yeah. I fuck with fairy type. I really like how things are in, like, pretty much up until, like, Sun and Moon, I like how things were. I really like Mega Transformations. Mega Evolutions, I mean. And then they fucking took them out of the fucking game for some reason. Even though they added, like, a whole ton of, like, depth to combat because Megas could even, like, change type when they Mega Evolve. Now let's just fucking take it out. Why not? Don't. No! God damn it. What's your favorite gen slash game? Oh, I mean, it's really hard to not say Gen 3 because that was how I started playing Pokemon, was fucking getting Ruby on the GBA. Very difficult to not pick that. I don't know, though. Honestly, this one might be, like, my, like, individual game-wise. Like, Pokemon Colosseum might be my favorite. I just really like the whole fucking, like, stealing Pokemon shit. And even the no wild Pokemon thing is, like, I don't really mind that. I think it's kind of cool. Yeah, I don't know. Oh, you're deep in the game? Sorta. I guess I'm kind of deep. Like, I really just have no interest in, like, new Pokemon games until they finally, like, take a risk and try to, like, do something that's cool rather than just, like, spitting out a fucking carbon copy game again. So, like, I really, really like this game for the... just because it's, like, weird and different and creative. Like, I love that. Hey, man, just found your YouTube channel and all the other... with your Liza P video, loved that. Love your sense of humor in the best of videos. Can't stay long, but was wondering if you plan on playing Returnal at some point. I have that game. I don't know if I did see your comment. I saw you commented on one of the videos. You said, quote, can I pay you to make a video about Returnal? I don't know if that's gonna happen. I probably won't make a video about it, but... it's a cool game. I like Returnal quite a bit. I do like it. I mean, just this whole, like, era, like, the GameCube in general was such a, like, Nintendo was doing such, like, cool, weird, experimental shit, and they just don't do that anymore. Just in general. It fucking sucks. I hate it here. Uh-oh. We're definitely gonna go have to grind a little bit. I'm thinking we'll have to do a little bit of grinding. A little bit of the grindstone. Everyone's got to remember their first coup stream. Yeah, everyone put... I'm, like, curious. What was the... Everyone put a chat with the first time you watched my stream. Razor Leaf. I know what Phoenix's is. I will never forget what Phoenix's is. Get out of my fucking car. It was BioShock? When the fuck did I play that game? Oh, man. It's unfortunately gone a little under the radar since it was initially a PS5 exclusive. Oh yeah, Returnal? No, I've had my fucking eye on that game ever since they announced it was gonna be, like, on PC. Because I do not have a PS5.
But I have one on my throne now, hee!
Yeah, I recently realized you can just buy a PS5 normally now. Like, it's just, like, on Amazon. You don't have to, like, wait in line for 7 days to even get, like, a chance of buying one. I don't believe you. Go check! Go fucking check! It's been a few years. Yeah, it's been out for a while. I honestly never thought it would happen in our fucking hell world. I thought it was just gonna be like a rare artifact forever until the PS6 makes it even more rare. Suspiciously wealthy tech industry furries, you know what to do. yeah. Alright, well, may as well go down with a fight, huh? Hey, I appreciate it, Greaser Man. I am so glad everyone likes the new video. Share it around everywhere. Send it to your friends. Hey, here's something you can do if you ever want to, like, help my videos get out there. Post them on Reddit. Post them on... I know what I just said might disgust a few of you. But just trust me on this. Because I can't post my own content on Reddit. That's, like, against the rules on, like, every single board. And even if you do, it just, like, doesn't go anywhere. Post my shit on, like, fucking our videos, our gaming, our Lies of P, etc., etc. Just be like, hey, someone just made this new fucking video about Lies of P, and it's really cool, and you should watch it. Breathing Reddit with my rad suit and Geiger counter. Is there a video essays subreddit? Maybe, I don't know. But like the bigger, more general ones are where like, if the post blows up, it'll like really blow up. Like our videos and our gaming, stuff like that. If someone finds this VOD, you're so blacklisted. That's fine. I don't fucking use Reddit. Whatever. I don't give a shit. That's why I'm making you do it. I'm fairly certain that I have two different Reddit accounts, and I literally just got an email the other day that a second one of them has been locked. And the other one has been suspended for, like, a long time for some fucking reason. I literally have no idea why. Wait, no, I do have an idea why. Someone posted, and it wasn't, like... They posted my whole horse video, the entire horse, but it was, like, a re-upload of the video, and it wasn't, like, linking back to, like, my video. And so I responded to that post and said, hey, this is my video. I'm Shinigami Eater. Here, you can find a link to it here. And I got suspended from Reddit. For being like, hey, this is my video. Insane. Right, I was clearly doing self-promotion, so. And that's not allowed. So I pretty much have not used Reddit, except for to like I don't ever post on Reddit, but I do like check boards for stuff sometimes. I'm gonna bring out Entei. And he is unfortunately going to replace Cash Money. Here's the thing, chat. Cash Money might be getting left in the dirt for now. For now. Asterisk for now. Just because, like, a grass type is not going to help me in this fight whatso-fucking-ever. Whatso-ever. Give me this fucking item. Deposit. Give it to dog 2! EXP share, there it is. Cool. And then I'm going to switch out Granbull. So Granbull can get some fucking experience. Alright, we're doing fucking Mount Battle again. Let's start a new challenge, why not? Yanma is still being underutilized. He will have his time. He will have his time. I'm not even gonna look at the moves, I'm just gonna hit A. What's the difference between this game and the mainline Pokemon games? Oh. Gosh. No wild Pokemon. You catch all the Pokemon by stealing them from trainers. Or rather, they're shadow Pokemon and you have to purify them after. Fucking. This is like some weird region that's like, yeah, almost Western based. It's technically not a mainline game. But it does, like, feel like it should be. It's cooler than the mainline games. It is. 100%. It's got that Zoids aesthetic. Oh my god, you're right. Wow, Zoids did have that, right? Takes place in a fucking dust bowl. Oh yeah, it's double battles only. I totally forgot that that's not normal. Yeah, there's that. You begin at level 25, and you have two starters. Neither of which you get to choose. You just get Umbreon and Espeon. That's like your Pokemon.
Wow, a whole year.
Hello, Reno B. Thank you for the 58 months of being subscribed to me, you bastard. Can I get a fucking Reno B bastard in the chat, please? Does that emote still exist? Awesome. Awesome, it still exists. Great. Oh my god, you have an Ash emote? Yeah, I love the Evil Dead. It's one of my it's Evil Dead 2 is like my favorite horror movie ever. The only proof online that I am real. Hey, Ku, weird question. What's your go-to comfort food? Oh, pizza. Definitely. I need to, like, stop eating so much pizza. This is a lifelong struggle for me. I have eaten so much fucking pizza in my life, and I will continue to. Unless fucking divine intervention happens. What kind of toppings? I mean, usually just cheese and pepperoni. I like meat pizza, though. That's got, like, sausage, ham, bacon, stuff like that. Watched Evil Dead 1 and didn't like it that much? How much better is 2? Okay, first of all, I don't know what the fuck you're talking about. But second, it is better. If you didn't like the first one, though, like, I don't know if you'll like the second. Like, the second one is just the first movie, but, like, crazier, more elevated. It's got a bit more budget. Looks nicer. Like, hate. I know. I'm just giving you shit. Yeah, I mean, I think I specifically say Evil Dead 2 because it's like it is better, if you ask me. What I wanted from the first one. This sounds like a big improvement. It is. It's like it's essentially a remake and also a sequel to Evil Dead 1. Yo, Greaser Man, thanks for the fucking sub. Cause like Evil Dead 1 was like they made it for like a few thousand dollars. Like almost nothing. They had like almost no money whatsoever. But like 2, they at least had like a decent budget to make cool shit with. And they fucking did. Yeah, that explains a lot. Yeah, Evil Dead 1 is like a shoestring budget. They were like actually out on the street just like asking for people to invest in the film, and they just like only had that money. The proper double feature is Evil Dead 2 / Army of Darkness. Yeah, for sure. Here's the thing, I really like Army of Darkness. It's great. I'm so glad it exists. It fucking introduced a lot more like world building and just like awesome shit to Evil Dead. But like just the ending of Evil Dead 2, like imagine if Evil Dead 2 came out and it ended the way it does, where he gets fucking sent back to the past and everyone's like raising their swords. Hail! Hail! No! No! Imagine it ends that way, and then another Evil Dead movie never comes out. Can you fucking imagine? How fucking sick would that be? Like, we, that's just how it ends. And without Evil Dead, we may never have gotten the Spider-Man movies. Oh, yeah, for sure. For sure. Not in the form that we did. That's for fucking certain. Evil Dead landed fucking Sam Raimi and Bruce Campbell on the map. They were just some, like, broke kids from Detroit. Ending your stream by sending you back in time. No! No! God, that fucking scene goes so hard. What a fucking way to end a movie. I used to have, like, for a long time when I was a teen, I had, like, a shirt that was just the S-Mart uniform on it. And it had, like, a name tag that says, like, hello, my name is Ash. And it was, like, the coolest fucking shirt that I owned.
Hail, he who has come from the sky to deliver us from the terror of the Deadites!
What's your opinion on the whole Jason Voorhees is a Deadite thing? I've never fucking heard of this. That sounds incredibly lame, though. Sounds like a theory that someone who's really lame came up with. What's the coolest clothing item you've ever owned? Oh, it's hard to not say my fucking Dudes Who Rock leather jacket. Hard to not say the piece of merch I had that's a fucking, like, I mean, it's faux leather, but still. Hard to not pick that. Oh my god, cinematic universe, whoa. I hate that shit, man. When people try to make, like, connections between shit that just, like, don't exist. I mean, I guess that's what, like, video essayists do. That's kind of, like, part of my job now, but I mean in the sense of, like, this giant media franchise is connected to this giant media franchise. I had a pullover hoodie that was designed to look like Edward Elric's jacket, and I wore that shit every day for 5 years. Oh, fuck yeah, dude. Dude, I remember being in, like, middle school, and I had the pocket watch, and I fucking wore that shit everywhere. I had that shit in my pocket. I was a fucking middle schooler carrying around a pocket watch like a fucking geek. Oh my god, dude. Anytime someone was like, what time is it? I'm like, hold up. Like, guy who carries around a knife anytime someone needs to cut something. Yo, I can take care of that. You need to know what time it is? Hold on. Let me check. Dude, disco. What's it like being cool? It's pretty cool, let me tell you. It's pretty cool. I guess soon we can swap out Granbull and maybe bring down another Pokemon's shadow level. I still use the Kushop desk mat for Yu-Gi-Oh! Tournaments. Whoa, cool. That's awesome. Dude, I'm so glad that that's what it's being used for, specifically. For Yu-Gi-Oh! Tournaments. If you buy the fucking shop.kueater.com Bloodborne A World Without Hope desk mat, you better fucking play Yu-Gi-Oh! On it. Oh, fuck, you have a desk mat now? It's always been there. I think it launched with the store, when I launched the new store. Pretty sure. I need to make some new shit. Sometime soon, we gotta have another sick, twisted merch drop of some kind. There's also, I remember, I think Fourth Wall is like getting rid of zip hoodies or some shit like that. They keep sending me emails that are like, hey, we're getting rid of these items. So I have to like change some shit on there because I haven't updated it in a while. So some things just like might not be available right now. Need more of your godly comfortable t-shirts? Are they really comfy? I actually don't own one, so I don't know. I tried to make sure they were the comfiest ones. Like, if you're gonna buy a t-shirt on my store, they better be it better be a nice t-shirt, right? All white hoodies are unavailable. Yeah, that's been there for a little bit. Those have just been, like, out of stock. If you want to get a black zip-up, they should be available right now, but I think they're getting rid of them soon. I got my buddy the Willem Dafoe Blunt shirt for his birthday. It was great. Dude, awesome. I'm so glad. I need to smoke a blunt with him. Can we get a new Willem the Enemy shirt? No. No. First of all, one-time deal where I just put Willem Dafoe's face on a t-shirt and sell it, which I'm like fairly certain you're not supposed to do. That was a one-time deal. But also, Willem is our fucking friend. I don't want to hear anything else. Like, when I was making the 420 drop, when I was, like, getting it set up, originally the theme was going to be, and you can tell by, like, some of the designs, originally the theme was going to be all designs that me or my friends made in the span of an hour or less. And pretty much all of them ended up being that. Pretty much all of them ended up being that, except for, like, Except for the, like, Resident Evil, like, items one that I made. I spent a little bit more time on that one. Oh, man. We could level up Yanma. It's an option. Could bring Yanma with me. Or we could bring Meth. We're gonna bring Meth. No, but Meth's already I should do with Shadow Pokemon. Just to like get them cleared. Yeah, let's clear Yanma, why not? Murkrow's going in here? I forgot Yanma doesn't evolve in this game yet. Oh my god, you're right! They don't! Holy shit. It took 4 weeks of grueling labor to make Captain Rip. Yeah, Beast design is awesome. Dude, Captain Rip of Bongulon 7. Pichu! Shitting right now goes pretty hard. Oh yeah, shitting right now will never... It'll never go away. I'm a huge fan of the Fool. I really, really love how that design came out. Yeah, that's right. I really, really like how that design came out. Robbie did a fucking fantastic job drawing that. Really glad I got to cement a Robbie Dude design into my shop. I'd be shitting right now, but I'm in the bath. Like to send prayers. Coward. We were supposed to rule this city. You make me sick. I'm so glad that audio has been going around on TikTok lately. Coward, you make me sick. We have a world to conquer.
Leave me alone.
Yeah, I would really... I don't know if this will happen for sure. So don't bank on this happening. I would like to do a Halloween merch drop. That would be really cool. I don't know if that'll happen, though. So we'll see. Sheesh! Yo! Cade Zuka, thank you so much for the purchase. That's really cool. Anyway, I'm staking my life on it now. Alright. I mean, that's something I've wanted to do forever, right? Like, release, like, cool fucking Halloween-ass designs for stuff. Fucking love Halloween, bro. maybe I'll start working on some shit soon. We'll see. We'll see.
Skelly screams, Skelly popped.
Yo, Hibby Bun. Thanks for the 27 months. I fucking... It's hard wearing 9 hats, man. But I do love wearing them. They are all delightful hats that I love wearing. Being a streamer, a musician, a video essay guy, doing fucking like graphic design, social media shit, fucking voice acting sometimes, etc., etc. Me when I wear 9 hats, TF2. Screech! What the fuck does Screech do? Sharply lowers the defense. Ooh. Yeah. Oh. What's the optimal stacking technique? Make it look like shit, where they're all, like, off balance, and it looks like they could fall apart at any moment, but actually it's the most structurally sound. We thought about doing this so long ago and haven't done it, so I'm just gonna talk about it now. Me and Jackson had an idea of opening a store at some point where we just would make designs based on, like, movies and video games and stuff. And just, like, just start selling them under, like, a different alias. That might still happen at some point. Who knows? It's essentially like Rucking Fawtin, like fucking Creep Illusion, like, you know, there's a million stores that do that. Playing chicken with the cease and desist. Hey, I mean, we would cease and desist if that happened.
A hex upon Amazon Prime for constantly breaking my streak.
Mars friend, thank you so much for the 14 months. Yeah, that sucks. A place to make all the merch you wish existed. Pretty much. Pretty much, yeah, that was like the idea, right? Like, damn, it'd be really cool if there was something with like this design I'm imagining on it. Someone should make that. how every fucking project in our friend group starts. Damn, it'd be really cool if someone made this. Wait a minute. Remembers that I have free will and I can perform actions. Me when I remember I have the power. For real, for real. If there's something you fucking wish existed, like, you can be the one who makes it. The time will pass anyway, bro. Creep Illusion as a Pontypool shirt? Yeah, I love Creep Illusion. I'm a big fan of Rucking Fawtin, but like some of the Creep Illusion designs go harder than anything on Rucking Fawtin. They had a Cure shirt. They had a Cure long sleeve on Creep Illusion that had like the red X's on the sleeve, and that like they stopped selling that like right before I watched Cure for the first time. I'm so fucking mad I will never get that shirt. Because it's gone now. They have a design on there right now that's all about fucking Melania from Elden Ring. And that's also a really fucking sick design. Maybe it'll be on eBay for scalper prices. Yeah, no, I'm not doing that. It's not, I don't want it that bad. It probably is, though. I've like checked just out of curiosity, and people sell like old rocking font and shit on eBay. I mean, that's the thing, though. That's what I like so much about making my own merch designs, right? Is like, I can make this look however I want. So that's like, that's the mindset I've tried to use whenever I like make new merch, is like, do I think this is sick and would I wear this and think that I look awesome wearing it? Then it's a good design. Mets. Dumb Mets. Combating terminal green Zelda shirt syndrome. There's nothing wrong with the green Zelda shirt. Or cargo shorts, or the combination of the two. Live your life. The way that Abra dies in this game is, like, scary. It looks like they're having, like, a fucking seizure or something. Like, every time it happens, it's like, oh my god, I'm sorry, should I call someone? Oh my god. What the fuck? You play Dante's Inferno on stream? If you make merch of that, I'll buy it. What would I mean? Like, just Dante's Inferno, but it's me. The giant, like, bone scythe and his fucking outfit, like, does go pretty hard, I gotta say. Satan's hog. Yeah, it's got like the main design on the front, and then on the back it's just like a giant fucking Satan's cock. Party in the back. It'll be really cool one day if I can really fucking get this, you know, this video essay shit going. You know, maybe I'll have a little bit more money down the line. Maybe I can actually pay artists to make shit. I won't have to make everything on my fucking own. My body is a machine that turns sins into absolved sins. Awesome. Hold on, Googling Satan. Yeah, I'd fold. Wow. The more I hear about this Satan guy, the more I don't care for him. What, are you gonna hate a guy for having a fucking enormous dick? This is why people fucking hate me, man. This is why some people online can't stand me. Great delivery on dick. That's just how I say dick. That's just how I say shit. I got a comment on the Bloodborne video today. Maybe the most, like, poetic compliment I've ever heard in my fucking life. Somebody commented on the Bloodborne video and said, "You speak like a sunset." What? What the fuck, dude? That's it. That was the whole comment. They didn't say anything else. Let me make sure I got that right. I'm gonna check. Hold on. Yeah. From someone with, like, a cat picture for their icon. "You speak like a sunset." Insane thing to say. They want you so bad. No, come on. I know, it's so beautiful. So beautiful. I once got told I would be good at reading bedtime stories. Yeah, it's just a nice thing to hear. Even if that's not your, like, you know, related to your job or anything like that, or what you do. It's nice to hear you have a nice voice. Feels good. Why is Bug super effective against Dark anyway? I don't fucking know, because they needed it to be effective against something. They needed an extra fucking matchup for balance, and it didn't matter if it made sense or not. Bugs don't fear the dark. You ever seen a cockroach in a dark room? Well, it's dark, I can't see nothing. So no, I guess I haven't. Ku Shedinja or Ninjask? Oh man, I don't even remember what they look like. Let me look him up. Shedinja. Okay, I like that guy. Shedinja. I like his, like, halo. I think it's cool that he's like a bug angel thing.
Bam, bam.
Good. Pokey coupons. Very good. Very good. Yes, yes.
What's Yanma looking like? He's alright. He's getting there. Pokemon has so much batshit lore, I love it. Well, I mean, to be fair, a lot of it is, like, speculative. Like, just, like, theories that people have just run with forever and, like, repeated so many times that people just take it as fact now. But yeah, there's some cool stuff in there. You got any opinions on the new Lords of the Fallen? Yeah, it looks cool. When does that come out? I forget. It looks pretty sick. October? Fuck me, dude. Every fucking game ever is coming out in the next 3 months. Stop it. Stop it. I know, it's fourth quarter, I know. It's, like, been happening, though, for the last, like, 2 months already. There's too many video games. Means there will be plenty to catch up on when new releases start dying. Yeah, it's just that, like, as a streamer, specifically as a streamer, like, obviously my experience is different from just, like, the average consumer. Like, I try to play stuff on the stream when it's new, and every single fucking video game is coming out in the span of a few months. That makes it impossible, because, like, it's going to be more exciting. People are going to want to see it more when it's new. If I play some game that came out, like, 6 months ago, it's not really, like, you know, the excitement isn't really there. The game industry should fucking fold around my needs. Me. Me! Thank you.
I need to play new games. That's not what I said.
It's not what I said.
I said when a new game comes out, I would like to play it on the stream.
Did you play Remnant 2? No, I did get a key for that recently, though. Like, literally last week, they gave me a key for it, so I'd like to play that at some point. I asked for a key before it came out and was hoping to get one when it was coming out, but, you know, now I have the key and now every fucking video game ever is releasing, so I don't know.
Spent money on it like a normal asshole. I mean, you know, I gotta see if I can get shit for free where I can.
What with, you know, this being like my job, I'm fucking constantly buying video games. I would like to not buy as many as I can avoid. And also, I'm fucking broke. One of your 9 jobs. Exactly, exactly.
It's tough out here, man. You cannot make it, like, on the internet. You cannot have, like, a job like this without doing, like, at least 3 or 4 things. Or getting extremely lucky.
Gotta save up money so he can buy hand meat or whatever the fuck was going on in the last stream. I don't eat hand meat!
Rumors of my cannibalism have been greatly exaggerated. It's true! People are just making shit up about me, I'm telling you.
Dude.
The VOD was literally called I Don't Eat Hand Meat. It's because I don't! It's a declarative statement. I don't.
I was just talking about how I have, like, a desire to taste human flesh, and someone just started talking about how they think hand meat is the most delicious part. That's all. Don't start with this, chat. We had a whole fucking discussion about this last week. Don't fucking start with me.
I like not getting prions, but I would try the lab-grown meat. That's what I was talking about, the lab meat. That's what I mean. Not like a person. I don't want to eat like a person. But that shit they make in labs, that's synthesized with DNA to just like grow it. It's not from a person, they just grew it in a lab. But it like is human meat. I want to try it. Don't tell me you don't want to try it. What specific person would you have them clone for meat? I don't have someone in mind. No, that now that's weird. Now we're getting into like really weird territory. And I want it to be this exact person. No. They could give me fucking stock human A. I don't want it to like be someone in particular. That's fucking weird, dude. Like, in the future, people will do this for streamers that they like, right? Spending $5,000 to, get a steak made from the DNA of my favorite VTuber. This is the fucking future that we can look forward to. It's terrible. I know. It's awful. That's why when you mentioned that idea, I was like, no, I don't want to do that. I don't want it to be someone in particular. I don't want the fucking lab assistant to, like, look me in the eyes and ask, like, who do you want us to use and have an answer for them. Have you checked your CO2 batteries lately? No. No, I haven't. I want to eat the cloned flesh of the creator of Calvin and Hobbes so I can absorb his power. What the fuck? I'm so... Dude, if anyone's watching the VOD right now and you, like, just got finished watching the other VOD of Pokemon Coliseum and you're just like, bro, are they talking about the fucking lab meat again? I'm so sorry. It's not my... Someone else brought it up. It's not my fault. I don't want this to be the subject of discussion every fucking week on the Pokemon Coliseum stream. But the community demands it. You should start adding the cannibalism tag to your streams. Dude, if I do that, I'm gonna find out about a whole, like, subsect community of Twitch that I had no idea existed. I'm gonna fucking gain incredibly horrific knowledge. That's a fucking dangerous road to go down. Someone, someone like who works on like the back end of Twitch, like monitoring like tags that people are using and shit, and he sees like, huh, it looks like someone just added a cannibalism tag. Should we check this out just to make sure everything's like good? Maybe we should check it just to see if it's kosher, you know what I'm saying? Oh, but I am concerned. How familiar are you with the furry community? Well, I'm fucking talking to you, Chucklefuck, so I'd say intimately. No, I have a ton of friends who are furries. Fucking, why do you ask? The Vor people's spidey sense just went off, and they're logging on to shinigamieater.twitch.tv. That's not the URL, first of all. But second, if the Vor community wants to fucking support my stream, by all means. By all means. Their money's just as good. We accept payment from all individuals here. Sopping wet money. Ugh. Gross. Man, this sucks. They're out there, man. They're real. Yo, Drewster, thank you for gifting a sub to Vor. Yo, who got the username Vor on Twitch? Holy shit.
Golden.
Come on, Yanma. Fucking whatever. Look, all I'm saying is if people who are watching the stream are into Vor and I'm openly saying that that shit is gross to me, they don't fucking care. They've heard that a million times, I bet. It's probably a normal occurrence for them. Whatever. You could like Vor and watch my stream. What am I saying? What am I saying?
Dude, this is some good weed. Dude, this weed is so good. I'm smoking weed. I'm smoking.
May God have mercy on chat BC I want.
Peeps to coffee. Thank you for the 420. Something you'll regret. Whatever. What? They're people. Whatever. It's better than being like a racist or something. Like, who cares? That's people.
Da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da-da
Coup spitting, kinksters are generally good people.
Yeah.
Fucking, that's just people, man. We like to joke around here, we like to kid. But at the end of the day, like, that's just, you know, whatever. Gives a shit. I'm changing. Why did that make me fucking laugh so hard? Message in chat from Rat with a degree. I'm changing. Oh my fucking god. Holy shit. Yeah, like into a werewolf or like what? Holy shit. Oh my god, man. The beast is breaking free. I'm changing! Saying I'm changing is so fucking funny. The past, like, month of streams have been a really special kind of unhinged. Really? Like, the past month in particular? It's interesting. If it includes Kid Rock, why wouldn't it include Kid Rock? The Alien Isolation streams could never have produced this kind of dialogue. Yeah, I don't know. I mean, like, I do think that my streams are just, like, better than they used to be, frankly. I had a lot of, like, weird attitudes about, like, the way that my stream needed to be run. Like, the types of jokes I would make and stuff like that for, like, the first few years I was streaming, and I've grown, like, a lot more lax about that. Like, specifically, like, what we were just talking about. How I was just talking about, like, I don't care if there's people who are, like, have, like, kinks in the, like, in the chat, whatever. A few years ago, that would have been a strict, like, I don't even want to hear about it. Because when I started streaming, I was so concerned about there being any, like, talk of, like, sexual shit or anything like that on my stream. Because I was so worried that that would be, like, a slippery slope to, like, people being weird about it, or, like, it, like, you know, when you're an influencer online, when you're, like, a voice to people, you know, obviously you have to be careful. You can't, like, be doing sexual shit with fans. And I was afraid that that would get, like, very quickly, like, misconstrued as that. Because I don't want to do that, but also, like, I don't need to worry about it that much, man. Like, I really don't. Like, whatever. It's fine, dude. You can talk about cum. Well, that's never been an issue. That's never been a problem. But, like, you guys remember, like, there was the whole, like, no yearning thing. That was, like, a running gag. But, like, the way that started was, like, I was serious about it. when people would talk about how they wanted to, like, fuck a character that was, like, in the game I was playing or something, I was like, hey, don't talk about stuff like that. And I was serious. I was sincere. You can do that now. That's fine. Catholic coup arc? I wasn't Catholic. I mean, it had to do with, like, stuff that happened in my personal life, too. Like, I'm not gonna get into it, because it is extremely personal shit, but, like, there was also, like, stuff that happened to me that definitely influenced that. I try to keep myself pretty restrained when it comes to explicit comments. Yeah, I mean, well, I don't even fucking do that anymore, right? I've said some shit on the stream when, like, a hot character appears on screen. So, I mean, if even the streamer can't fucking stop.
Come.
That's right. But it's cool now that Dollop is 27. Oh my god, that was it, because I'm 27. I've been 27 for almost a year now. That must have been it. I turned 27. That had to have been it, man. Dude, my birthday's in fucking November. I'm gonna be 28 years old. I'm coming up on the big 3-0. It's approaching. Scorpio spotted. Oh my god, dude. I was just having a discussion with Robbie and Meeks about this the other day. Because Robbie just, like, hates fucking astrology shit so bad. And Meeks asked, what month were you born in? And I said, oh, I'm a Scorpio. And Meeks said, oh. And I immediately was like, shut the fuck up! And Robbie was like, see? See what I mean? I was like, I know! I hate it! Scorpio behavior, to be honest. Whatever, dude. Like, whoever came up with that shit had, like, a bunch of bullies, and they fucking figured out which months they were born and said, these ones are fucking dicks. If you're this sign, you fucking suck. You suck shit, and you're mean and rude and a horrible person. But if you're these ones, you're good and balanced, and you have great energy. Why do you have beef with a month? You know, whoever made Chinese Zodiac made it so that they were born in the year of the dragon. Yeah, man. I I work a job with all my coworkers in their early 20s and I look young, so they try to talk to me about extremely 23-year-old problems and I have to try desperately to care. Oh my god. I also have coworkers who are younger than me. As, dude, I can't believe how big the split between being like a late 20s person and being an early 20s person is. It feels like the divide is about 30 years between me and my coworkers. I have two coworkers who are like, who are 21 and 23. And they are like children to me. Ugh, I hated her tone. Ma'am, with all due respect, I'm 30 years old. Oh man, it's insane. I got a coworker who's like 25 and every day she says a new word to me that the youths have been apparently saying for months. It's fucked up, man. The flow of time, it just keeps on moving. I have a guy at work who info dumps Garten of Banban lore at me. What the fuck? What the fuck? What? Wow, that sucks. That fucking sucks. I would fucking complain. I'd like make some shit up and get this person fired for doing that to me. You should kick their ass. That is awful, dude. Like, it's already pretty bad when someone just, like, dumps a ton of shit about, like, something you just don't care about on you. Like, regularly, especially if it's a fucking coworker. But Garten of Banban, dude. Garten of Banban, by the way, is a very shitty, like, children's mascot horror game, for anybody who doesn't know. It's terrible. I've watched Meeks play literally all of them. They're fucking awful. Awful video games. I'm 32 and my current manager is only 3 years older than me. She's pretty laid back, which is nice, but I still have to watch myself from opening up emails to her with, "Hey, sup?" Hey, what's up? You gotta start emails with the hello. Sometimes if I'm feeling spicy with it, if I'm like sending an email to like a publisher's PR email or something to like ask for a key. Sometimes I'll hit him with the howdy. But otherwise you gotta use the hello. It's just like standard email shit. How many times has howdy worked? A few. A few. I mean, it's hard to say if it worked or not, or if it just didn't matter. But, I mean, I've gotten responses to emails that started with howdy before. My current manager is only 10 years older than me and super hot. Unrelated. Bro, you just wanted to talk about how your fucking manager's hot. I said to her once that I'm built different, and I got the blankest stare back. I'm built different. I just, like, I don't know. I've never had a problem just not saying, like, online lingo to people in real life. I don't know if, like, others have, like, more difficulty with that or something, but it's never, like, I've never had a moment like that where I was talking to someone older than me and I, like, busted out an internet slang thing. Used to work at a place where one of my coworkers' favorite pastimes was trying to interrogate us younger employees to see if we listened to the same music they did. The older coworker, maybe 20 years on us, would not see success for several years. Really gotta read the room at work, yeah. I'm built different, capable of talking like a normie. Yeah, I don't know what to say, Chad. I guess I must be built different. I've always had a higher than average ability to converse with fucking old heads. To appeal to their sensibilities, you know? That probably has something to do with the fact that I was raised for like half of my life by my grandparents. That might have something to do with it. And my grandparents are cool. They're not like... My grandparents are cool. Like, I've talked about this before. My grandma was the head of a district of AFSCME. How do you fucking say it? AFSCME? It's a big old union. Huge union head. Fucking AFSCME. The union that works for you. Like, they tell me stories about, like, when they were on, like, strike and shit in, like, the 80s. In, like, the 80s and 90s. Stuff like that. My dad was like a union business agent, and basically every other guy in the union was like a free bonus dad. Wow, that's cute. Fucking AFSCME, the union that works for you. I should put that on again. It's
been a while since we watched that. It was a joy showing that to my grandmother, who had no idea that that existed. Like Yanma's little, like, stinger teeth that they have at the end of their tail. Scary. This is a threatening Pokemon. Shout out to grandmas. Absolutely. Abso-fucking-lutely. Like, between both of my grandmas, one of whom passed away, like, a long time ago at this point. I don't know, like, over 10 years ago, something like that. I was, like, my entire childhood, I would be at someone's house. Either my one grandma or my other grandma. It fluctuated. Like, I did not want to be home. I wanted to be there instead. Grandma's house is the fucking holy place. The holy place of rest. Hello, I just demolished a big-ass bowl of honey pepper chicken and rice, and now I'm here to breathe in everyone's faces. Awesome, thank you, Phoenix. Let's go spent most of my early childhood at grandparents' house, gang. Yeah, man, for real. At one point, my grandparents wanted to adopt me. It didn't end up happening, but that was like in the cards at one point. They like were my fucking parents in no small way. What's Yanma looking like? Wait a minute. Has it not been going down when they're in fucking whatever the fuck hyper mode? Does it not go down? Fuck me, dude. Does it seem like it has gone down? I didn't know that. It goes down, but slower?
I'm changing.
Fuck. That sucks, dude. Can I come back? I can't come back, right? Yeah, I'm pretty sure. Oops, wrong way. Yeah, we'll come back and do more, but I'm gonna go cure Grand Bull first. Stop! Because Grand Bull's fucking meter is empty. I think if you have money, you could give your shadow Pokemon massages in Agate Village to drop meter outside of battle.
Oh.
Okay. He's probably got an assload of money now. Oh yeah? No, I don't. Doing Battle Tower does not give you any money. No, I don't!
Doom, 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 doom.
Wah, wah.
I fucking love the Agate Village theme so much.
I know! They need to make the new fucking... They need to make another Pokemon Western. Do you get money from the battle challenge things in the towns? No, the main way to get money is Coliseum battles.
Ooh. Dude, let's go. Let's fucking go, dude. Let's fucking go, dude! It's like our highest level fucking Pokemon. What are we naming this Pokemon, chat?
Dog will hunt! Dog will hunt!
Dog Zero? Butter dog, dog with the butter, butter dog. Grandma. I like that. I like Grandma. Just having a Pokemon whose name is Grandma. 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 Cute. Here comes Grandma. I thought this guy just showed up like he wasn't there before. Like we came out and just.
Hey.
Dude, I love referring to it as lore walking. Lore walking is so funny. Like I'm recording a fucking like VODI video. Some sort of Lies of P lore video of some kind. Mount Battle. Continue. Oh, I forgot you could just start in any of the areas you want. I forgore. Dude, meth.
Do some grinding.
We got like an hour left until I gotta stop for movie night. By the way, movie night tonight. If you're not familiar, you can hit exclamation movie night. It'll give you the link. Every week we watch a movie on Friday, 12 a.m. Eastern. Tonight we're watching Heat. 1995's Heat. Essentially Payday the movie. Which I thought was appropriate because Payday 3 is coming out soon. Great ass, the movie.
She's got a great ass. Something about an ass, a woman's ass. When I see one, something comes out of me.
It's a good movie, but I cannot stop thinking about the Robert De Niro in Heat post.
What?
Can you inform me what you are referring to? Post is the only thing I've ever heard from it. Robert De Niro in Heat? Hey, yo. I don't know what post you're talking about, yeah. Uh-oh, something has just appeared in the Discord. It's just an ask from an anonymous person that says, Robert De Niro in Heat, and I'm not apologizing. And the response is, forgot Heat was the name of a movie, and I had my finger on the block button. Old Koo would not have laughed at that? No, I would have laughed at it. It was just regarding streams that I lament about that shit. Of course I would have laughed at that. Robert De Niro in Heat. Fucking rules. Al Pacino in Heat. Movie's got fucking Robert De Niro. It's got Al Pacino. Fucking Val Kilmer's in that movie. The other guy is there. I forget who the other guy is, who the actor is. Remember when Al Pacino just showed up at the Game Awards? Yeah, and then fucking... what's his name that plays Kratos won that award?
Al Pacino in Heat sure is a phrase to enter the stream to.
Hawthorne Vamp, thank you for the 27 months. And then Kratos' actor won the award and had like a speech that's like 8 minutes long, and Al Pacino was like standing in the background the whole time. Christopher Judge, thank you, thank you. Just couldn't remember his name. Al Pacino, fucking legs about to buckle. Was never meant to stand for that long. He fucking deserved that, dude. Like, it was a great speech, though. And he fucking earned it. His performance as fucking Kratos is, like, legendary. If and you ask me. Oh, man. Do I want to get Refresh? No. I don't think I do. It's a move you can just fucking supplement items with. He's Kratos to me now instead of Gold Guy? What? What does that mean? Do you just mean the old actor for Kratos? Because I grew up with that guy. Like, he is still he is a Kratos to me still. I hate those new God of War games. You what? What the fuck do you mean you hate the new God of War games? I'm ignoring everything you say from this point on. Ignored. Ignored. Ignore them, chat. What don't you like about them? They fucking add so much depth to the character. They're incredible games. I don't know how you could not like those. Looking away. Ragnarok has the hot version of Thor. That's right. That's fucking right, dude. Fat Thor, bro. That's how it should be. It was just boring. I don't want to fight different flavors of trolls for 17 hours. You're insane. I'm ignoring you. Ignored. In this guy for 60 seconds. That'll show him. I'll happily play another God of War, though. Love them all, just not the new two. Did you just say you didn't play Ragnarok? Maybe you should fucking give it a try. Post Gex all you want, chat. This is what I'm talking about. Those games are fucking good. There's literally two moments in the fucking story where you fight a troll. I don't even think there are any in Ragnarok, actually. Just the first one. Every couple seconds, hell, it's a troll with a big brick. We straight up didn't play the same game, bro. That, like, doesn't happen. That literally doesn't happen. You fucking went on a trip and hallucinated the whole time. We did not play the same game. I'm gonna Google it. Do you fight a troll every few seconds in God of War? The troll version? This guy had troll mode activated. You put in the secret fucking cheat code in the main menu that turns every enemy into a troll. Dude, troll mode. The anti-piracy copy of God of War. That would be awesome. Oh my god, that would be so awesome. Holy shit. In total, there are 10 trolls. It's a 40-hour fucking game, dog! And, like, most of those are optional fights! What are you talking about? Too many trolls. It's got too many trolls in it. It hit my troll quota, so I don't like this game. IGN! 7 out of 10, too many trolls. I have absolutely zero investment in changing this person's mind. I just think it's funny to talk about this. That is, like, literally the thing that everybody who, like, doesn't like that game always says. Too many trolls! Either that or they made Kratos into a pussy! The Halo model swap streams, but every other model in the game is trolls. Dude, that was awesome. Having the fucking, the, like, first fight where I had the, like, Master Chief and Doom Guy skins on. That was so fucking cool. In the next God of War game, Kratos will have gay thoughts. You'll have to, he'll have another child and you'll have to choose between gay son and thought daughter. That'll be one of the, game-changing options that you get at some point. He's Greek, of course he has gay thoughts. True. Hashtag gender fluid? Dude, gender fluid Kratos? The woke mob has invaded God of War, and they made my favorite video game character gender fluid? How could they? They can't fucking get away with this.
they're making Halo 6 and Master Chief is a trans woman? How could they do this? That's just Metroid. Holy shit. Oh my god, dude. Fucking Nostradamus over here. Oh my god. Wow. Wow. Gamers, I just got the news. Skyrim with the pronouns. Fucking pronouns! Dude, what an insane person. Holy shit. I watched that clip of that guy who went on that fucking rant about Starfield and how there's pronouns in it. What a fucking insane man. He got so angry. Like, I would just hit the fucking X button, bro. I would have just hit the X button and been done with it. Fucking pronouns! That guy is I am referring to a streamer slash YouTuber named Heels versus Babyface, which the name is obviously wrestling terminology. That guy used to make a ton of videos about WoW, and I actually used to watch him a little bit, like just very casually. Like I watched like a few videos of his back in the day about WoW, and ever since like 2017 or so, he just like started just becoming insane and super like right wing and weird about it. It was so weird because if you watch his old videos, he's just like a normal guy. He's just like a normal guy who's just like makes videos about like the latest WoW update or something. It's so fucked up. If you play WoW enough, you go insane. I guess. Have you seen where right-wing science... There's right-wing science denier anti-vaxxers on TikTok that are saying that glasses are a hoax? And no one in human history has ever needed glasses. No way. What? Really? That's so fucking funny. Holy shit. No one has ever needed glasses. Oh my god. Yeah, you caught me. I was faking it. I just thought it'd be funny to wear these around, see if anybody said anything. What? Like, I've heard a lot of, like, as someone who watches, like, a lot of, like, leftist shit on YouTube, especially, like,
videos of people just, like, roasting right-wing people who are insane, like, just for fun. Like, I know about a lot of those, like, really crazy, just, like, fringe theory people. Ooh, dude, we got psychic! But, like, I've never heard one quite like that. Holy shit, that's really funny. I'm just gonna get rid of Attract. I don't want to get rid of Psybeam because Psychic only has 10 PP. 10 PP? And, like, obviously the source of a lot of this shit is, like, grifters that are, like, trying to sell something. And, like, so, like, most of the time they don't even actually, like, believe the thing that they're trying to make everyone else believe. But it's still just, like, so funny. Like, a person actually fucking thinks this. A person who lives in our world and experiences the things around me. The same things that I experience. Let's try out Psychic on poor old Love Disc. It's a grift from Big Glasses. I still cannot believe the YouTube channels I used to watch in 2016. What, did you watch a bunch of people that, like, are insane right-wingers now or something? Happens to all of us. Happens to the best of us. If you freak out every normal person you know, all you have left are your fellow ideologues. Cults make people insane on purpose. Oh yeah, for sure. It, like, is by design. There is, like, behind all of these extremely fucking silly, ridiculous scenarios, there is someone who is doing it on purpose to, like, reap benefit. My friend used to make me watch H3H3 with them in high school. high school's another time. That's fucking, everyone did stupid shit in high school. Former JonTron watcher. I mean, that one, dude, the JonTron thing was, like, crazy. Cause his, like, videos are like, generally so clean of, like, any political leaning type shit. And then, like, that interview came out. What was it? What did he do? He did, like, a debate with, like, Destiny or something. And he just said, like, the most insane shit ever. It was nuts, dude! It was nuts! Did you ever hear about all the Achievement Hunter shit? Oh yeah. Oh yeah, of course. Yeah, dude, everything at that fucking company is all fucked up. It's a fucking nightmare. I used to watch a lot of Achievement Hunter back in the day, too. That one, like, kind of hurt. That one, like, similarly to the Game Grumps thing, it was like, ugh. Like, I picked up isms from these men.
You know what I mean? Fucking loved Michael. Yeah, that's what I'm talking about. They're like old videos of them playing like Minecraft and fucking GTA and shit like that. Like, oh my god. I used to love watching those. Not the isms. I mean, when you fucking... It's literally, I don't know how to tell you this, Chad. It's literally happening to you in real time right now. When you watch someone for so long, when you, like, consume their stuff for so long, like, you do, like, pick up little parts of them. It's just, like, how it works. And even after, you know, down the line, in 10 years when I get canceled for running a... sacrificing innocent people factory or something like that. Those things are still gonna be there. Like, things that I picked up from fucking, like, Game Grumps or whatever, like, that's still part of me, even if I, like, don't like those guys anymore, you know what I mean? It just happens. For eating hands, mostly, yeah, right. Long after Coup Eater gets fucking canceled, you're still gonna be eating hands. I'm still in awe that you were in a Nostalgia Critic video. Hey, me too. Hey, me too. Oh my god, dude. We can't stop doing... We gotta stop doing this. Elaborate on that. Every time someone brings this up, there's people in chat who don't know, and I have to fucking... I have to show them. Hold on, let me fucking get out of this fight first. Oh my god, I think Game Grumps is why I say real talk. There's all kinds of shit I say that's like, I definitely picked this up from YouTuber and animator Aaron Hansen at some point. And even more things that I picked up from YouTuber, musician, and guy who likes to do weird shit with his fans, Dan Avidan. It's just the way it is. It happened. This is who I am now. Can't change it. Man, at least Barry got out. Dude, Barry still like streams and stuff. He like streams all the time. Dude, good for Barry. Good for Barry, man. Oh, I gotta pull up the video. Hold on. Since it's everyone's gotta know. Everyone's gotta know. Nostalgia Critic Demolition Man. Okay, so all right, so let me tell you this story, chat. So it all begins with... So there's this video, right? The Demolition Man Nostalgia Critic video. So he made this video in, like, when was this? 2015. I think it was either 2015 or 2014 when this happened. So, me and my friends went to a con known as Midwest Media Expo. If you're familiar with Yomacon in Detroit, Midwest Media Expo is in the same building. It's run by the same people, but it's on, like, the opposite end of the year. It's, like, in, like, the spring slash summer, whereas Yomacon is in, like, October, November. And it's just, like, general. It's not really, like, anime-focused. It's just, like, whatever. Nostalgia Critic had a panel there that my friend wanted to go to, because I was there with, like, three or four friends. So we weren't doing anything at that time, so we were just like, yeah, we'll go to that with you. Like, what? Like, none of us really watched Nostalgia Critic except for this one friend. So, at the end of this video, they have a part of the video that they filmed at the convention.
Hail your new Lord and Savior!
Dude, my hair was so fucking long. My hair was huge. So yeah, I'm in a Nostalgia Critic video. That's just there forever now. That was my friend Evelyn, by the way, the person whose hand they were holding. My friend Evelyn and another friend of ours, they were dressed up as like punk Peach and Daisy. What fucking time is it? Yeah, we can do a few more fights. How did it feel to be in the presence of the Malcolm? I had no fucking idea what was going on. I had never, ever watched anything Nostalgia Critic related before that. Ever.
Truly.
You should have killed him when you had the chance.
This is what everyone says. Every time, every single time I tell this story, someone says this. That I had the chance and I could have taken the shot. Nostalgia Lover, thank you for the $3. Thank you. Remember when Ego Raptor and Doug Walker fucked on Demo Reel?
What?
What the? What are you talking about? There is an implied sex scene. Is this like a series they were in or something like that? What's Demo Reel? I don't know. No, I know what you're talking about now. I completely forgot. Because the only reason I know about that is from a video essay I watched about it. I know which series you're referring to now. I just forgot that was the name. Remember when Darkside Phil watched a Mega 64 Todd and Aaron skit during the Spike TV Game Awards and live tweeted about how he didn't get it was satire and thought it was just two annoying, unfunny guys who exist IRL? That's awesome. No, I don't remember that, but that fucking rules. Game of the year! Call of Duty! I fucking love Todd and Aaron. Every single year has to be bookended by Todd and Aaron, or that year may as well not even happened. Year ends without Todd and Aaron, the human race goes extinct.
Oh shit. Oh shit. Dun 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 dun.
Please don't watch Todd and Aaron. What? Why? Don't tell me you don't like Mega 64 either. We're about to have a problem. Dude, the look emote is so fucking funny. The look emote is so fucking funny. Looking up at the rest of the chat. Nah, I just think the human race is ready to be extinguished. Oh, okay. I understand. Puts the heavy rock that I was holding down. Oh, it was a joke. Is playing wrestling heel for the whole chat room. I see we got a audience full of fucking marks today.
Everyone who watches this stream smells like shit. Shut up! Hey. Dude, I've got heat. I got heat with the crowd. It's always really upsetting watching wrestling when someone, like, turns heel or there's, like, a new wrestler that comes in and they're, like, and they like, start as a heel and, like, no, like they're trying to do heel shit and nobody in the crowd, like, gives a shit. They're just, like, not even responding. It's like, oh, man, I feel fucking terrible for this person right now. Favorite wrestler, any company? I really like, I mean, I only really watch AEW. I really like Malakai Black, or just the House of Black in general. Sorry, I'm completely blanking here on names. Chris Statlander. MJF, obviously. The devil himself. Really glad they got rid of that fucking shithead CM Punk. Things can go back to fucking normal now, now that that fucking loser is not in the locker room anymore. Stupid dickhead cum punk. Let me think. Orange Cassidy. Yeah, Orange Cassidy. Dude, Orange Cassidy's match at fucking All Out with Jon Moxley was insane. Watching Orange Cassidy, like, care is awesome. For anyone who doesn't know, Orange Cassidy's whole bit is that he is someone who is, like, he perpetually has, like, a hangover, and he, like, comedically, like, puts very little effort into his matches. Like, he'll just, like, apathetically, like, roll out of the ring, and so, and he'll do this bit where he, like, he, like, walks up to the other wrestler and starts hitting them with, like, the most obvious, like, faux punches ever. Like, they're really slow and they're just, like, obviously a joke, and the whole crowd fucking loves it. Me and my friends always refer to him as the Bugs Bunny of AEW. Is that the guy who always has his hands in his jeans? Yeah, yeah. His wrestling gear is a pair of jeans, by the way. And his, like, one of his, like, moves that he'll do, that'll do to, like, power up is to put his hands in his pockets. And he'll wrestle with his hands in his pockets. It's awesome. Orange Cassidy rules. Maybe I should watch wrestling? Yeah, man, that's what I'm saying! What do you think I've been saying for the last, like, 2 years, chat room? Wrestling is fucking awesome. It rules. Especially right now, dude. AEW right now is, like, awesome. The last few, like, pay-per-views they did, if you can go to, like, a site that has, you know, maybe an illicit site of some sort that may have pay-per-views available to watch for a lower amount of money than they're supposed to be watched for. Maybe I've linked it in Cum Chat before. I don't know. You should watch All In and All Out, the two pay-per-views that they just did. Because they were fucking awesome. I'm not invested in wrestling at all, but the day CM Punk got fired was great because my entire timeline was either haters going, thank fucking God, or thirsty women reposting screenshots from a match where Punk was getting beaten bloody with by a big chain and going, I miss his body. What? I miss his body, bro. Oh man. He did have, I mean, like 2 years ago, he did have he had a dog collar match with MJF. And that is like one of the hottest wrestling matches I've ever seen in my life. For the record. A dog collar match is just a wrestling match where both the wrestlers have a dog collar that is chained between them, so they are constantly chained to one another. It was fuck, I used Dragon Dance again. That was an accident. It was fucking awesome. Okay, fine, I'll watch wrestling. I'm telling you, man. There is all, like, there are a million reasons to watch wrestling, and all of them are valid. All of them are, like, great reasons to watch wrestling. And if it's just because you want to watch, like, hot, sweaty men beat the shit out of each other, and also hot, sweaty women, that's reason enough, man. That's reason enough. Something for everyone. Yeah. I'm an enjoyer of all the aspects of wrestling, personally. Including the hot, sweaty men beating the shit out of each other. Most of my favorite wrestlers are either dead or retired. Have you been watching AEW lately? Because there's a lot of wrestlers to fucking love, man. I'm telling you. Some really fucking talented people. There's a wrestler in AEW named Maki Ito, and her thing is she's a former idol that got kicked out for being bad, and now she's a wrestler and does idol shit in the ring. Dude, Maki Ito fucking rules. She's awesome. She's in, like, WWE, right? Maki Ito? Or what is she? I forget where she wrestles. But there's, like, yeah. There's all kinds of wrestlers, man. There's somebody that you will gravitate to if you start watching wrestling. I guarantee it. Like, the reason I like the House of Black so much is because they are the fucking awesome. They are the, like, goths who come out wearing, like, skulls with antlers on them, and their whole thing is they, like, teleport to the ring when the lights are off and shit like that. They're fucking evil, and I love them.
Danhausen got injured and that sucked. Yeah, I love Danhausen. I've been waiting for him to come back. I was just talking about this the other day. We were watching Dynamite on... Or no, it wasn't Dynamite. We were watching something. Maybe it was last week or something. And I was just like, dude, where's Danhausen been? He hasn't fucking been here in a while. And I was like, oh, right, he got fucking injured. That sucks. I want him back. Do I need to start watching wrestling now? Hey, I'm just like, hey, if you're someone who is okay with and knows how to, you know, access media in a less than legal way, it is very easy and will be free to do so. And there is so, so, so much wrestling that you can watch. And it happens like 5 fucking times a week. Every week. It's theater, yeah. I mean, yeah, legitimately. Like, wrestling is one of the last bastions of just, like, theater. That's 100% like what it is. It's just performance. What happened when a jock became a theater kid? Basically. What did I miss? We're talking about fucking wrestling. We're talking about one of the 5 things that we rotate on me just talking about constantly. Wrestling is just redneck anime. It's like, it is very anime. And I think that you would be, maybe actually you wouldn't be surprised at just like how many wrestlers, especially like young ones now, are like huge anime fans and like clearly try to like work that into what they do. It like, it super is just anime.
We gotta put all the cool topics on a bingo board.
Mute radio, thank you. Kenny Omega, absolutely. Kenny Omega came out as Sans in an entrance one time. It was a Halloween episode of Dynamite, and he came out to fucking what's the fucking song from Undertale, and he came out dressed as Sans for an entrance to a wrestling match. Megalovania, yeah, thank you. Yeah, Andy came out as Sephiroth in Japan one time. His finishing move is called the One-Winged Angel. Kenny Omega. That's like his signature finishing move. Ku's wrestling gimmick is a heel who is badly hiding the fact that he's a cannibal and eats every jobber he beats. I win the match and it cuts to commercial and then they cut back and I'm still in the ring and there's like a finger. There's like a finger and some blood on the ring. And I'm wiping my mouth with a napkin.
Wrestling is cool because sometimes it's the most dramatic storytelling put to real people beating the shit out of each other. Other times it's about a guy who can't be beaten as long as he spins raw pizza dough. Dude, I love that guy. I know exactly who you're talking about. I mean, like, Orange Cassidy has a whole thing where, like, his, like, finishing move that he often wins the match with is called the Orange Punch, and it's literally just, like a jumping punch that he does. And, like, before he does the Orange Punch at the end of a match, he'll always take his, like, arm, his, like, elbow pad thing that he's wearing off. Like, he has it on for the whole match, but once he takes the fucking pad off, you know he's, like, serious. It's his limiter. He takes it off and he drops it on the ground and it goes, poof, like fucking Rock Lee. I'll do one more match. And then we gotta fucking wrap this shit up. Orange Cassidy's power level is insane.
Yeah.
Like, we talk about this all the time. Orange Cassidy is the most powerful wrestler, like, canonically. But he just, like, can't be fucked to care. Like, he is the Goku of AEW. But he usually, like, doesn't care enough to, like, use his full power. He has this really funny thing that he's been doing lately, where, like, his during his entrance, he'll come out, and you know how, like, when wrestlers come out during their entrance, they often have, like, fireworks and pyro going off and shit, especially the ones that are, like, really popular. Orange Cassidy does a shitty thumbs up where he, like, doesn't raise his thumb all the way up, and a single pyro shoots out of a tube. Like, a single firework comes out of a tube behind him. It's awesome. Goku would love AEW. For real. Absolutely. I'm surprised no wrestler has done the weighted clothes bit. I'm sure someone probably has. I mean, there's so much wrestling that we don't even, like, hear about normally, because, like, there's indie wrestling. Like, there's tons of indie wrestlers that have never been on TV before. I'm sure somebody does that. Go to a fucking indie, if there's ever, like, an indie wrestling show happening in your town, go to it. You will have a fucking fantastic time. I don't care if they're fucking hosting it in, like, a school gymnasium. Go to that fucking wrestling show. Because, like, indie wrestling is where you'll see shit like, oh my god, Altair from Assassin's Creed just fucking threw Pikachu through the table. Oh my god. I gotta show you guys the Hood Slam video, dude. Oh my god. Hold on. Can I find the fucking Hood Slam video? I need to show you guys this video. This is what we're ending the stream on.
Well, we didn't have video games in the 20s.
people fucking blowing puffs of smoke into the ring and shit.
Jackson! I said fucking yo-yos!
Yo-yo.
Hood slam. Smoke arena of time. It's Kratos! Oh my god! The God of War! I can't believe it! It's Wario! I never thought I... Oh my god, it's Mario, Luigi, Peach, and Daisy! Oh my god, it's Simon Belmont! It's Link, the hero of time! It's Cammy's ass from Street Fighter! It's Ken! It's this guy! I don't know who this guy is! It's fucking, it's Ryu and, Akuma! It's Mega Man! It's, that guy from Mortal Kombat. He's got the eye. What's his name? I forget. It's the other guy. He's got the arms. Jax. Jackson Kano. Friendship? Dude, like, look. This is wrestling, dude. Can you imagine being there when this happened? This would be so fucking hype. This shit's awesome. It's Altair, dude, from the top rope! I fucking love Altair. Doing, like, actually crazy shit. Look at this, dude! Altair's fucking assassinating Mario and Luigi right now. Wrestling floor bounce equals anime crater impact. You're like, you're right. Like, you're right on the mark. That is 100% what that's like. Watching people do this shit, it's awesome, man. It rules. Fucking cool.
What?
We'll watch a little bit more, and then I gotta wrap it up. Dude, Simon Belmont. I'm interrupted by a phone ring. Sometimes I wish I never got the motherfucking thing. Hello, hello, can I speak to Big E? Yo, who this? Tanisha, your call back, I'm busy. Why don't you hit me on the box a little later? Dude, the ref with the mask? Beam struggle. I remember, I think the Young Bucks came out as dressed up as Ren and Ken and Ryu. They came out dressed as Ken and Ryu for Halloween one year. Dude, the Pharaoh? This mashup is so funny. Anyway, man, This is wrestling. Watch wrestling, dude. Just fucking watch wrestling. It's awesome. I'm gonna show Art. Now I'm about to hit ya. Got some art here to show. Robin released a whole new fucking highlight video. It's like an hour and a half long of another one of the Pokemon Coliseums. It's part four of the Pokemon Coliseum edits that they've been making. These are awesome. You should really go watch them. They're in the Bone Zone art in fucking the Discord if you want to find them. There's also some art that they made for the video that's like in the video. Here's me as a child pulling up grass instead of playing soccer. And here's me on my late night TV show where I have exclusively guests that are really tired. And here's Phoenix giving an announcement about the Good Burger 2 trailer. And last, of course, here's Phoenix being obliterated. Being obliterated and turned to ash. Very good, very good. Thank you so much, Robin. These have been awesome to see. And this is from Maxiomatic. They just posted this today. Had to scratch this one out real quick because he's on the last Pokemon battle of the stream. It's me with the hand beat on a fork. It was grown in a lab. It's fine. Me as a fucking heel wrestler. That would be an awesome gimmick. Clearly a cannibal and trying to hide it. That actually rules. Thank you, Maxiomatic. Chat, that's the stream, so thanks so much for watching. I'm going to leave now and get ready for movie night and eat some food first, actually. What's a fucking raid message? Good for Barry. Friendship. Let's do that. I like that. Friendship. Oops, I almost spelled it wrong. Let's raid. Dude, let's raid a fucking wrestler. Why don't we? In the spirit of things. By the way, tons of wrestlers are also Twitch streamers. There's a huge crossover between the two. We're gonna raid Brandon Cutler. Brandon Cutler is watching some show from the 90s. Come to movie night in 35 minutes. We're gonna watch Heat. I'll see you there. All right. Good night, everybody. Bye.